Hi, this is an educational video about acupuncture and its use for treating headache conditions. Before we get into the specifics, let's take a look at how the information is organized in this video. First, I'll describe acupuncture and explore how it works. Then, I'll identify headache conditions for which acupuncture may be most helpful and explore how acupuncture may help relieve your symptoms. Finally, we'll take a look at what medical acupuncture may look like from a patient's perspective. Acupuncture is an ancient Chinese medical practice. From this perspective, acupuncture was used as a way to reopen a bodily energy path called qi. This was done by using very small needles, similar to the width of a human hair, and placing these small needles in specific points just below the skin to treat different conditions, including pain conditions. Practitioners of Western medicine are now researching how acupuncture works on nerves, blood vessels, and organ tissues. The National Institute of Health has found medical acupuncture to be effective in treating pain conditions like fibromyalgia, head and face pain, and associated nausea and vomiting. The U.S. military uses battlefield acupuncture on parts of the ear to help active duty service members with muscle and back pain. For migraine and tension-type headaches, acupuncture has been found to reduce the overall number of days that a person experiences headaches. Many medical organizations consider acupuncture to be a good alternative for short-term headache relief. The study of acupuncture and acupoints, or the specific areas of the body related to symptom relief, is an area that is gaining increasing evidence in Western medicine. It is important that you receive a complete evaluation that explores your headache, physical and mental health, as well as your family and medical histories before you begin acupuncture treatment with any provider. This will ensure that acupuncture is safe and appropriate for your individual needs. With acupuncture, while relief may be immediate with new onset pain, chronic conditions may require several sessions. It is recommended to attempt 4 to 6 sessions to give your body and symptoms time to adjust to the acupuncture procedure. Sometimes patients may become very, very tired during and or after an acupuncture session, and relief may last anywhere from a few hours to a few weeks, depending on your body's response. The Department of Veterans Affairs, Office of Patient-Centered Care and Cultural Transformation has been doing a lot of work to help VA implement its whole health system of care. This is an approach to healthcare that begins with understanding veterans' life missions and purposes, or what matters most to veterans, and then provides care to improve veterans' overall health and well-being. Practices such as acupuncture are quickly growing treatment options for veterans receiving care in the VA. Now, let's examine some risks. Although acupuncture is generally safe and serious problems are rare, there are some risks. Many patients may be uncomfortable with needles. If you have a fear of needles, speak with your provider or an acupuncturist about ideas for overcoming your fear. Additionally, needles that are not sterile can cause infection. Make sure that your acupuncture practitioner uses sterile needles that are thrown away after every use. In some acupoints, needles inserted too deeply can puncture the lungs or other bodily organs or cause problems with blood vessels. That is why it is important to use a practitioner who's well trained in acupuncture. People with bleeding disorders or who take blood thinners may have increased risk of bleeding. Electrical stimulation of the needles can cause problems for people with pacemakers or other implanted electrical devices. Pregnant women should talk with their healthcare provider before having acupuncture. So, what are some next steps? If you prefer Eastern approaches to health and well-being, or experience headache symptoms on a regular basis and no other treatments seem to be working, speak with your primary care provider about the possibility of acupuncture. You should discuss your individual risks and benefits with a practitioner who's trained in acupuncture. Please understand that acupuncture is not a one-size-fits-all, as individuals will have different responses to acupuncture. In summary, acupuncture is a process typically carried out by physicians or other trained practitioners who've received appropriate educational and clinical training. It's an ancient Chinese medicine practice that involves placing small needles just below the surface of the skin to affect how nerves, blood vessels, and organs function. Acupuncture has the most scientific support for treating migraine and tension-type headaches, although it may be effective for other head and face pain conditions as a complement to usual medical treatment. If you prefer Eastern approaches to health and well-being, or if you experience headache symptoms on a regular basis and no other treatments seem to be working, speak with your provider about the possibility of acupuncture. You should discuss your individual risks and benefits with a practitioner who's trained in acupuncture. Please understand that acupuncture is not a one-size-fits-all, and individuals will have different responses to acupuncture. Acupuncture may work better in conjunction with other treatments for headaches.